order for you to be great and understand other culture, you have to know first your roots. Because music reacts with visual arts teachers. But with music, the element is sound and it travels through the air. So it's, you know, it's oral. So what happens to that is that if I'm a composer and if I will write music that is about shimmering light, how could I write it down or how could I compose such shimmering light, depicting shimmering light through music? Because if I give you a pattern or something about light, then I'm very sure each listener would have different point of view of what's shimmering light. So like, for example, so it's not, this country is not a developed country compared to England and Germany and Japan. So as you know, as always the critic said, art will only flourish if the country has a very good economy. Because if the economy is not good, definitely that country will never prioritize arts first. Arts will just come along if everything is okay, but of course arts is the essence of life. Eh? You know, whatever you see, whatever you hear, you know, written by or composed by different composers, painted by artists, their depictions about, you know, the reality, about life, creativity, imagination, you will be aware how important art, not just music, but, you know, everything, life in general, that if there's no art, there's no, life has no essence at all. So the history of the violin dates from the 15th century, so from the time of Renaissance period. So, what you see now, this is a modern violin, but it just only changed a bit, 20%. Because if you compare it with a Baroque violin, which is the real violin, the real setup of the violin, from the period of Stradivari, Guarneri, and Amati, the fingerboard, which you can see this black thing, is actually shorter. A certain angle will be elevated like that, there is more power. So that means that the bridge it will also be elevated, so there is more tension to the string. So if there's more tension, there's more energy and projection for the string to vibrate. Because during their time, violins were only for this room, like for the nobles, for the kings of Europe. So I'm very sure you're familiar with the Four Seasons. You're familiar with that, right? And the, you know, popularized by Vanessa May as a rock like storm. That's also the part of Elite. It's in French, Elite, the summer, by Vivaldi. So it's popularized by. But if I will play. Oh my god, that's so good, and something like that. Because for them, that's really music. So for me, it is music. It's being sung by Celine Dion, but of course, it's still the same. It's still, you know, if you're comparing the recipe of Chef Laudico to McDonald's, something like that. It is good, you know. It is good, but it's still junk. It's still junk. I mean, we can produce probably instruments that can mimic the human voice. And that's the reason why the violin was invented, because this is the only instrument that is closest to the human voice. So the first class music instrument is the voice, and then it's the violin. Because the piano cannot make a vibrato. Piano, you cannot press the piano and vibrate, you cannot do that. So it's only the violin. You could make a vibrato with a violin. It's really like human voice. Of course, apart from that, I'm not just particularly saying about the violin, also the viola and the cello. breed dogs. So. By Beethoven, that's the last symphony. You know, he made this for 30 years because he keeps on revising it. And of course, during the war of Napoleon Bonaparte in Vienna, so when he tries to write his speech, he can hear canyons, you know, being bombarded, the palaces in Vienna. So everything is just renovated, okay? So the reason why, during Romantic period, the violin, this is already the setup of the violin during the late 18th century up to the 19th century to the present. Because the time where there's already Paganini and the fingerboard, they want it here. Because Paganini, when he plays it, he's considered to be the legendary violinist and the violinist of all time in the world. So up to here, during the time of Bach and Vivaldi, it's only up to here. So the fingerboard is just already being limited up to this part. But right now it's here, it can rise up to four octaves. I'm gonna play Paganini. It's very romantic. It's not by an adjective romantic, but romantic as a noun, romantic period. Okay. Cantabile. So this is a sonata.
Dessert for now.